welcome here to the Executive Diversity of Technology in Moscow on behalf of the Local Organizing Committee and wish every success to our proceedings in the next 2 days. As you see there, the sun is, should be shining now because of the work we carry in, normally does. And we're only about 200 meters from the sea, but please don't be tempted to go away during the sessions. I'm sure there will be interesting things to keep us all busy here. Before we go into the formal proceedings of the day, I'd like to just say a few words about our university and our interests here which relate to the proceedings of this area. The university is a city university, is integrated in the central part of the Limassol city, and you can see in the figure on the top left, all the blue circles are various buildings of the university, so it's not very obvious, it's a little bit concealed. But you can also see, if you walk around within about 1500 meters from here, some of the more traditional buildings that landmark big buildings of the city that have been donated by the municipality to the university and that are used. The top one is the Senate House, where I was fortunate to have my office there when I was Vice Rector for Academic Affairs for 4 years. The lower left building is the library, and the one on the bottom right hand side is one of the lecture theatre complexes that we have here at the university. We are here. At the red arrow, it's about 200 meters from the coast. But believe it or not, we don't find time to go to walk that way. We see it when we drive to the university. CUT, as we call it, Cyprus University of Technology, is a young university. It's been in operation for 11 years only. And in this short history of operation, we can see that our university is doing well in terms of its academic output and performance, and it's been ranked consistently higher in a an upward trajectory in the last few years. The recent rankings of the Times High Education list have ranked the university in the top 300 to 350 universities around the world, and also it's the first in Cyprus and Greece, which is quite an achievement for such a young university. Of course, there is still a long way to go, and we're all working very hard. So, back to the subject area of the coursework that we are having in the next 2 days, which is focusing on the biostructural depth monitoring. This is an area which is very central to some of our own research interests here and activities. And I just want to say a few words about the things we have been doing that relate to this area and some of the new initiatives that we are trying to work on. Some of you may remember a couple of years ago I was invited to give a talk about the Smart and Marie Curie MTN program, which was focusing again on the use of monitoring combined with many other techniques to be able to develop smart proactive methods for design and integrity management of infrastructure. Of course, there are many other related activities. And recently we have established within the university a multidisciplinary group, research group, which we call Smart NI, where the focus is on smart solutions for sustainable marine and onshore infrastructure and environment systems. And a lot of the things that we're going to talk about here in the next couple of days relate to some of the main things that we have in this group. Our aim is to promote and develop world-class research and education, and also to facilitate industry uptake of safe and effective critical infrastructure developments through smart, proactive, and integrated solutions, emerging technologies, and so on. And you'll see some of the key focus areas we're working on. We're working on a range of techniques. Again, and you recognize a lot of the techniques. I'm sure we'll discuss related aspects during the workshop, ranging from monitoring, sensor signal processing, data analysis, risk analysis, updating, and so on, which find their application in design optimization, integrity management, lifecycle management, right through to holistic asset management and sustainability. The three key areas we are focusing are interested and focused here in Cyprus now into the emerging oil and gas industry in Cyprus and the region. So this is one of our key focus areas. But we also try to promote technology transfer, horizontal and integrated and holistic approaches across the three interest areas. And our mode of operation is really to bring together academia, industry and government and collaborate and integrate the regional way through this multidisciplinary and multilateral framework of operation. Here you will see the academic colleagues who are part of the group, and some of them are here today. Schools within the university, so we bring the multidisciplinarity here. And we have industry fellows with long experience in the industry, also contribute to our activities and also to our research fellows. Just a quick glance at some of the key project areas that we have worked on and we're working on. One is the smart library review, which I mentioned before. We have the joint industry program on safety environment protection of offshore oil and gas operations. We have also established a regional network of stakeholders in the Eastern Mediterranean region, which focuses again on collaboration on safety and environmental protection of offshore oil and gas operations. We have projects that deal with modeling of extreme oceanic waves, sea traffic management, innovative education techniques, robotics, we have training projects, other force projects, other aspects of smart technology management and so on. I will not go into the details of it. As I mentioned, the emerging area of energy, the energy industry, and the offshore oil and gas industry, but also the renewables, is of particular interest to us. Some of the current activities are focusing on aspects that relate to whether the modeling analysis, experimental aspects also are of interest to us, and monitoring, which is where the value of information comes in, where we try to develop and integrate techniques. We're in the process of establishing some new important projects, and we hope that in a future meeting we'll have another more to share with you. And the other very important activity that we started recently, we are working on a phase one study for the creation of a national center of excellence, where the focus will be on energy. The main motivation for and the reason for working in that direction is the emerging oil and gas industry, but we really try to have a focus, quite a focus on the energy. We expect that in this project, as it proceeds, there will be again a strong focus on smart infrastructure, monitoring and so on. So there will be areas of interest to this group. And we believe that the key element of success is government together. We have support from the state, from government, for progressing this and establishing this center. And also, we are working towards establishing a national and international framework of collaborators from different stakeholders groups in order to be more effective in our approach and our output. And in this context, as I said, there will be opportunities and very much welcome ideas for collaboration with yourselves in the areas that are of interest to this workshop. I hope I've given you some taste of where we are, the university, and what are the key areas of interest that are overlapped with the interest of this workshop, and which also open up opportunities for future collaboration. And with that, I'd like to close and wish you every success for the next 2 days. And I'll hand you over to Sebastian for the more formal business.